Hello everybody, it's Shakes. Today I'm going to be showing you guys how to increase your FPS in The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt. Now this game came out for nearly 5 years since I've recorded this, and this game is still one of the most beautiful looking games out right now. And despite the wonderful efforts of their developers to optimize the game, it is pretty well optimized, but because of the fact that it looks so nice, it is going to be hard to run on bad PCs or even decent PCs, because it just looks that good. It's an open world game, there's a million things happening, there's a million things in the RPG world, so obviously it's not going to run the best on a lot of computers. So yeah, this video is going to be helping you guys increase your FPS. If you have a terrible computer, it's going to make it a very, very playable experience. And if you have a decent PC, this is going to make it as smooth experience as possible and just enjoy the game way more, because the smoother it is, the more enjoyable the experience is. And yeah, without further ado, let's just jump right into it. If you could subscribe, that would be wonderful. The YouTube algorithm has finally realized I'm not a total waste of space, so it is finally recommending me. I'm getting a lot of traffic recently, so if you could hit that subscribe, that would be wonderful. We're gonna blow up this year, so yeah, let's just jump right into it. First thing you're going to want to do is open up your browser. Assuming you're not already on your browser looking at YouTube, I don't know what kind of witchcraft you're doing to be on YouTube but not on your forget about it. Go to razer.com/cortex/boost. It's going to be in the description, so that's going to help you out massively. And once you're here, just click on the nice green download button. It's going to download pretty quick. You can open it up and click yes. It's not going to be anything harmful to your PC. You can close out your browser. We're not going to need this anymore. And once this window comes up, make sure that you only have Razer Cortex checked. Razer Synapsis is for people who have Razer gear, and you know, you can make it light up in cool colors. Nice, cool, whatever. You're just going to want to have Razer Cortex checked. And then if you want to change your install location from here, I'm going to do that because I like installing myself somewhere else, like putting it in my program files, but you can put it wherever you want, or you could just keep your install location as it was before. That's totally fine. And once you're done, you know, you have it installing where you want, you can just click your install button. Now it's going to download pretty quickly. My internet is never usually this fast. I think they kind of do some kind of witchcraft to make it download super fast, so you get it as soon as possible. But anyway, it's going to download really quickly, and then it's going to install pretty quickly as well, so we can get our software fast. And as you can see, it's going to take a little bit longer to install. And once it has installed, you're going to get a nice, beautiful congratulations. Good job, you downloaded the software. Nice job. Make sure this is checked, and then we're going to click get started. You just got to wait a second, and then if it's not opening up, just go to your taskbar, click on it, and then it's going to have this nice little window. It's going to say login or sign up, but tucked below in muted colors is continue as a guest, so that's what we're going to want to do. We don't want to make a Razer ID for no reason. Why would we do that? And then once again, hit continue as a guest. You can close out of this, and this is where we're going to choose our game. Here's where we're going to find all of our games, so you know, you can choose whatever game you want. We're going to start up Witcher, but if you didn't have this open and you know it, you just close out of this. And we close out of it here. You don't actually have to do this, but if you just start up your computer and you want to get it optimized again, just make sure you can find this Razer Cortex desktop icon. Double click on it. It's going to open up really quickly, and then you're going to be able to, you know, optimize your games once again. So that's pretty much how you do it if you restart your computer or you just want to be able to, you know, use it on other games. So anyway, now that you understand that, we're just going to go to The Witcher 3, click play, and we're going to jump into the next part. So once you are actually in The Witcher 3, there's a bunch of different things we can do within the game that will increase our FPS. So the first thing you're going to want to do is go to your options and then go to the video settings. Go to post-processing, then change everything to low, and then just make sure all these other things are set to low, because sometimes when you click low, it doesn't bring everything down, kind of irritating, but it doesn't really matter. And also, a bunch of these things aren't even really useful, even if you have a ton of FPS, like blur and motion blur. These just are just irritating, and they just bring down visual fidelity. So overall, you're not losing that much when you turn all of these settings down to low. Now when we go to graphics, though, it's going to have bigger effects on our FPS, but it's also going to be a little bit uglier when we change the settings, so just keep all of that in mind. So the first thing we're going to want to do is take off VSync. VSync just adds input lag and just a bunch of other things that you don't want. It limits your FPS to 60. Some people say it looks smoother. It just overall isn't that great for your FPS. So just turn that off. Make sure your maximum FPS is changed to unlimited, just so you can push as much FPS as your computer can allow. So, you know, you get the smoothest experience possible. Go to your display mode and make sure that's on full screen, so, you know, your computer doesn't consider it just another window that it doesn't have to allocate all that much resources to. If it's on full screen, it's going to kind of know that it's a game, and it's going to be willing to push more into the game, so you can have as much FPS as possible. And for the graphics preset, change that to low, and then make sure everything is as low as possible for these things down here. Preserve system gamma on or off doesn't really have that big of a change, so that doesn't really matter if you like it on or off. Just keep it on or off, doesn't really matter in terms of the FPS. So next thing you're going to want to do after making all those other changes is turn down your resolution. Now your resolution has one of the biggest effects on your FPS, so kind of pay attention a little bit. Turning down your resolution will make you have more FPS. Simple as that. Why did I tell you to pay attention? Wasn't that tough to think about? Anyway, though, don't be afraid to turn down your resolution. Obviously, if you have to render less pixels, if your computer has to render, you know, half or a third as many pixels, then it's going to run a half or three times as much speed, what? In other words, dramatically reducing your resolution will just make you have dramatically higher FPS because you just have to push less pixels, which is probably the biggest thing that, you know, pulls people back from having good FPS. So once you're done with that, just click escape, and then it's going to, you know, make all the changes. And overall, I'm going to click enter, and if I go into game, you're going to see how it looks. So I'm going to, you know, I'm going to skip this sequence, and we're going to see how this game looks after we've made all these settings. And here we are in game. This is not the most beautiful area. This is not the most beautiful place or landscape in the game. I know, I apologize, but this is how it looks right now. But if we change it back, I'm going to show you how it looks right now. It looks pretty fantastic for how much FPS I'm getting. I'm getting currently 270 FPS. And if I change it back to 1440p Ultra, all million different settings turned all the way to Ultra, let's see how this looks, and let's see how much FPS we're going to get in comparison. So right now I'm getting about 85-ish FPS, so that's about a third of the FPS, and overall it does not look that much nicer. Yes, Geralto looks a little bit more beautiful, but Geralto always looks beautiful. That's not a concern to us. But jokes aside though, the nicer aspect ratio I wouldn't say is really that much worth it for how much less FPS I'm getting. Obviously 90 is a lot of FPS, so I'm gonna be just fine. But if you have a bit of a worse FPS and you're running at like 20 FPS P4 or 30 FPS and you're getting 90, or I don't know how to do the other math equation, I already forgot it. If you're below 30 FPS and you're making these changes, then it's definitely worth it to go up, because overall you're not losing that much visual fidelity for how much FPS you're getting. Personally, I'd recommend going for as much FPS as possible just so you have as smooth and as nice an experience. So just keep that in mind. So just keep in mind how much different it looks from the lowest settings to the highest settings, and how much difference of FPS there is from the lowest to the highest settings. As I said before, it went from 80 to 280, so that's about 3 times as much. And overall, I wouldn't say this is 3 times as nicer. I think the aspect ratio and a few of the details is quite a bit nicer. But outside of that, it's the same old game, and that's what we're here for. The smoothness of the game is what's going to make the experience as good as possible for you. So just keep that in mind. Keep in mind how it looked before and after, how the FPS has been changed. So yeah, that's how you can make your decision on what settings you want to change to keep your FPS higher. And yeah, that's pretty much how you can configure your settings to make sure you get as much FPS as possible, or tweak it so you can have, you know, a good balance between FPS and visual fidelity. Anyway, thank you guys all so much for checking out the video. Don't forget to leave a like if this helped or you enjoyed it. Don't forget to comment if you have any suggestions or just want to say anything. I read and reply to all comments. Subscribe if you want to subscribe. We're on the hype train to 100k. We're on our way. Hop on if you'd like. And yeah, thank you guys all so much for watching. Hope to see you guys in the next one. Peace.